Okay, I'm going in. I'm going in! Alpha Leader Bravo, going in. EKIA, in the vicinity. What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things, playing some Ark Survival Evolved Wagging on the Pooping Evolved server. Hope you guys are having a great day. I am having a really good day. Stuff and things are going great today. So we got a couple of eggs right here already. Also, these guys laid a couple of eggs. We're doing really great. You guys know I have egg fever. I mean, I'm not an eggologist, but I'm just saying I got egg fever. But you see what you said, that says right there? Want a beaver? Drax wants to know if I want a beaver. So, today, Drax has dropped off a super beaver at our old base. Fingers crossed, it hasn't despawned. When I dropped off, the other day I found a really high-level Giganto. I think it was like 90-something. I didn't really want it. I dropped it off over here and it despawned right away. Oh, there he is right there. There it is. Female Castoroids. 104. Holy moly, peeps! 104. Now, we're not going to have mate-boosted pair, which kind of stinks. Winona is a lady. I'm pretty sure. I didn't name this lady Winona and have it be a dude. So, yeah, but it's a 104. So, I think we're definitely going to be using some of our Gallimimus kibble. I'm so glad. Are you a lady for real? Yeah, just making sure. Oh, yeah, you got a level. That's what's up. Oh, you got another level? All right. So, I'm so glad that we tamed up those Gallimimus because now we can use that kibble to do stuff and things with. Holy crap, what's this? Is it another present from DMAC? It's another gift from DMAC. Welcome back to the club. Hey, thanks so much. That's awesome. So DMAC gave us another Mastercraft wooden club because we lost the one that we had before when we were taming Monstrosity. So awesome. That's cool. Thanks so much for helping me out, DMAC. I really appreciate that. Oh my gosh, that's a great kingly gift. All right, so we have a lot of stuff and things to do. First and foremost, we have to make some kibble. Now, I'm taking a look over here on my handy dandy calculator, and it's saying that 6 is going to do it for a level 104. So we have 32. Let's go ahead and make 16, and we should be good to go. Now, we're going to need, what is it, mejo berries, and we're going to need some thatch for burning stuff and things. And some fiber, if there's none inside of there. And then I'm not exactly sure what the meat and potatoes are for the Gallimimus kibble. But anywho, I'm going to get that going, guys. Oh, also, thank you guys so much for showing support on these videos. I really do appreciate it, guys. It helps me out so much. And you guys have just been great in doing it. So thank you very much. If you guys like this video, don't forget to smash that thumbs up button and show your support, peeps. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. So, all right, Gallimimus kibble time. I will be our bees, peeps. And we're back. We got a little bit of the kibble made up here. I thought I'd bring it back just to show you that it's cooked meat, jerky, and savory root. And also, I thought that maybe some of you guys might like for me to give you a little life update. I know some of you guys know that... Whoa. Super, super dark. What happened? Where did the sun go? And it's foggy. Yay! So I know some of you guys have been following like the vlogs and stuff and things like that. You know that me and my wife are trying to get away from Little Thunder. We've been looking at buying a house, and we're looking at moving to the Nashville area, or we're also looking to move into the Florida area. Oh, wait, no, we're on fire. Okay, calm down. Don't call a fire department, we're fine. So, the Florida or the Nashville area, and, so, we flew down to Nashville the other day, whatever, on February, pardon me, and we looked at, like, 20 houses. We looked at all these places, and, we didn't find anything that we liked. And it was really discouraging. It was really, really discouraging because we had made, like, you know, I figured we'd go down and we'd figure it out. Like, you know, we'd find a house that we really liked and we didn't. And then so we've been looking around and we've been looking on, like, the apps, you know, like different apps that you can use on your phone for that stuff. And we found a property that we like for a house that's not built yet. So, like, first, if some of you guys may not know this, but, and then some of you guys are from out of the States, if you're from other countries, I'm not sure how they handle this deal. But, you know, down here, they'll build, like, a little community, and they'll build, like, plots. And then you'll pick, like, your land. You pick a little plot of land, and then they have, like, different houses you can pick. It's like, it's I kind of don't like it. It's kind of like buying a house from a book. But there's a lot of advantages to having a newer house, a brand new house especially, too. Like, houses these days come with warranties and stuff like that. Like, it's really cool. So, anyway, we found a place that we really like, and in the Nashville market, stuff goes really, really fast. Like, we had houses that we liked that we were trying to go see that were gone in, like, less than 48 hours. So we really saw this plot of land that we really like. We found a house that we could put on it that we really like, and we have to move really, really fast. So within, like, a day, we decided that we have to go back down to Nashville, because even though it's a house we're ordering out of a book, there's some that are already built, and I will not buy a whole house that I have not seen. I just won't do it. Like, some people do that. They live their lives fast and loose, but that's not the Slipgator way. I want to actually see it. So, I've had to put out a huge amount of videos in a very, very short time because we only had like 2 days notice. So there's a little bit of time travel going on right now. You may be noticing some tweets if you follow me on Twitter at Slipgator. If you don't follow me on Twitter, follow me there right now at Slipgator, S-L-O-P-G-A-R. But yeah, you may notice some tweets or some pictures on Instagram of me traveling. And that's because we are going back down to Nashville again. And I'm really hoping that this is like the trip, this is the house, because it costs us a lot of money to like go down there and do that. Like, it costs a lot to like travel down over there and go and do this. So I'm really, really hoping that we close this deal on this new house. And then the crazy part about it is, even if we do close the deal on the new house, it's going to be like upwards of up to 6 months before we even move in. So because it's not even built yet. So pretty crazy stuff and things going on in my life right now. It's really stressful for me. I find it to be really, this whole process to be pretty stressful. Oh, crap. Oh, I made that big mistake. Here we go. There, we'll fix it. Oh, no, we did it again. Oh, no, we can't stop it. There's nothing we can do. So I'm trying to get them so that they're all in there so I can just tee them in and out. But when one empties, we'll just squirt it in that slot. But anyhoozle, that's kind of a little life update. I mean, it happened again. It's not super duper stressful, like end of time stressful. It's just a little bit stressful. So, but it's something that we really want to do, and we have to deal with it. And there's no other way to get around. Like, if you're buying a house, it's a process, and you gotta go along for the ride a little bit. The last house the townhome we live in now was like really easy. We literally looked at two places and said, "Let's do it," and we found this one like first. It was the first place we saw, and then within 30 days we had signed our papers and we were good to go. So it was a pretty painless process and pretty quick. This one's a little bit different because we're moving to a different state. But anyway, that's just some of the stuff and things that are on my mind. I figured I'd let you guys know about. But now we're almost done. 3 more Gallimimus kibble, and then we're on to beaver tamers. Super beaver taming times. BRBs, peeps. All right, guys. All of our kibble is made. We got all this hot egg action over here real quick we got to pick up before we get over there. All right, so we got our 16 kibble. I think that should be more than enough. I took a look at the calculator that I use, and it says that we should be good to go. So fingers crossed on that, because if it takes more than 16, we're going to be in deep trouble. We'll squirt that in there. We'll squirt some more of these guys in there. And then I also brought 80 trank darts for this guy. I don't think it should take near that many. That is the wrong vault. What? Hey, no, no. Don't contaminate my vault fiber. So it shouldn't take more than 80. But I'm not taking any chances. So also, you know what? We'll bring some. No, we should be good. There's no way it's going to take more than 16 kibble. There's just no way. Even it's not a Bronto. It's just not that big of a guy. So we have all the stuff and things that we need. Oh, you know what? We might not have. Hold on a second here. Do we have any narcotics? We don't. Oh, baby, hold on. Let's head back and grab some narcos as well and make sure we have all the stuff and things that we need. 300 should do it. What are you thinking? Thinking? Okay, 300 should do it. All right, so let's pack. And then right in here. Zip, 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 zip. One, a two, a 300. All right, there we go. Now we can head out here and see if he's here. If he despawned, I'm going to lose my control. I have a level of control, and I'll lose it. I won't know where it will have gone. My control. All right, where are you, Beaver? Oh, I don't see him. There he is. There he is. There he is. There he is. Okay. Okay. All right, Kyle. Slipgator, calm down. Slipgator. I know you want your super beaver. Oh my gosh. Why we can't get through there? Why? Hate. I don't know what we're gonna name the super beaver. Beaver Unum? I try to save the Unum names for stuff that's like really, really high level. So let's get into it. Oh, let's make sure we're on passive. Come here, Beaver. Come to me. Bring him to me. Rain of Fire reference. Check. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Can we get some brain shots right here? Oh, might not be able to. Oh, he's moving. He's moving. He's on the move. Oh, he's out of here. Where are you going, Beaver? Okay. Is he just going to attack the wall? Okay, I'm going in. I'm going in! Alpha Leader Bravo, going in. EKIA, in the vicinity. He's going to turn on me, I know it. Oh, whoa, he's going after the wall. Don't break the wall. Oh, he's coming after me. Oh, he bit me. Thank God beavers are slow. Not that slow, though. Let's make him turn a corner here. Huh? Oh, he's down. How many? That didn't take hardly any at all. Sweet. It's down. Or she's down. She is down. All right. There we go. There we go. We got some narcotics. Let's put this gun away. We got some narcotics on there. We got our kibble on there. The coloring is kind of meh. It's not the best coloring ever. I really wanted like a black and orange one. Those things look so cool. But you know what? Beggars can't be choosers. And we got to make sure we thank Drax so much for dropping this guy off. This super beaver is going to be awesome. And we're going to turn this into a battle beaver. I'm not going to turn it into... I could use it for weight and turn it into a weight beaver. But I don't think it's going to matter. You could take a look at that and see that its weight is about 372. To effectively use a beaver for some of the high-end crafting that we've seen, there's just... I mean, you'd need thousands of weight. And I don't think that that's possible. Maybe you could get close to doing some stuff, but not a lot. So, anywho, the point being, we've got our battle beaver down. We're going to go ahead and babysit, let it eat its kibbles, and then we will BRBs when it's tamed up, peeps. And we're back with our level 155 battle beaver. What's the statistics? Let's run it down, peeps. 2,000 HPs, 576 stamina, oxygen food, no one cares, 444 weight, 300 melee damage, 170% movement speed. Oh my God. And I got the best name. I picked out the best name I could ever pick out. Pickle Knuckle. That's the name for a battle beaver. I mean, it's a name that just instills fear. Think about it. If you were on the street, Pickle Knuckle, stay right there. If you were on the street and some guy came up to you in the back alleyway and he was like, "My name is Killface, Destroyer Black, Darkness, Shadow," you'd be like, "Meh, whatever. Yeah, that's a good name, buddy. I gotta go." But if someone was like, "My name's Pickle Knuckle," then I'd be like, "Don't hit me. Don't kill me, Pickle Knuckle." That is not, I mean, it's a fearsome name. And if you don't think so, then you're wrong. And Pickle Knuckle. So, all right, we got Pickle Knuckle, our battle beaver. Where did I drop you? Her. All right. So, over here. Also, it's getting a little laggy in the base. I'm excited to get rid of the scorpions at some time. So, beaver. No. It's going to be under Castoroids. Castoroid saddle means we need a smithy. We haven't even learned smithy engram since we did the mind wipe from the Amazing Race. Castoroids. There we go. Nail the days can't be stopped. Let's head over here. And see, we don't have a battle beaver. There's no way we got a battle beaver saddle blueprint, do we? No, I didn't think so. I just, sometimes you got to check because I don't know. Also, let's put away our kibbles because this stuff is valuable right now. We don't have a lot. We still have 18 eggs. It's a bit of a lie. I lied to you a little bit, but then I told you the truth right away. So it's not good, that bad. All right. So over here and then over here, we need our beaver saddle. Let us take a look at what it's going to cost to make hide. Metal cementing paste. Thankfully, I made some cementing paste just the other day. Let's grab a stack of hide. Let's grab 2 stacks of hide. Let's grab cementing paste. Oh, yes, we have just enough or a little bit over. And then we need 100 metal. Nailed it. Let's squirt it all inside of here. Aced it. Castoroid saddle. We're building it one day. 9852. Let's check out how much XP it gives us. 995. 100? Nailed it, Ace, it can't be stopped. All right, we got our Casteroid saddle. Let's cut over here. We need some a sweet, sweet die action. Let's grab 5 and 5. Actually, we might need a little bit more than that. This saddle has a couple of little sweet little thingy-doodlers. All right, so these guys look exactly the same. They're exactly the same color. So what do we go for colors on there? All right, let's maybe do a different color scheme on our Battle Beaver. Like so. Let's go with white straps. We need a blue. That. And then, what else can be blue? That. That looks good. And then, white scrolls on the side. Oh, yeah! Look at her! Pickle Knuckle the Super Beaver! Alright, so, let's put away some stuff and things here. I mean, the next order of business is... Wait, I left it on the Battle Beaver. The next order of business is to see what's going on with this Battle Beaver. Let's grab some food. I'm interested to see... We got to level it up. So I'm interested to see what we can do as far as getting in some hot level action. Trying to see exactly, like, how good it's going to do. Oh, let me check something else out, too. Yeah, they come standard with 170% movement speed. It's like the standard option for the Battle Beaver. All right, so now it's time. We got to see what we can do. I'm thinking we're going to take it up to 5,000 HPs. I don't think we need much stamina, and then we're going to start getting some hot melee damage action as well. So I think it's time for another montage, a Battle Beaver-rific Battle Beaver montage. Pickle Knuckle, take it away. Let's do this. Making our way, I think we're going to go to the North Island, peeps. So I've been doing some leveling up. I hope you guys liked the montage. Make sure if you did, you smash that thumbs up button and show your support. The worst thing about the Battle Beaver so far, she's amazing. Pickle Knuckle, she's pretty amazing. But I do have to say, there's one thing. We still can't heal. You may have seen me post this on Twitter, too. You still can't heal herbivores, and it really is frustrating because it makes it so that it's almost impossible to use one for more than a couple minutes. You get on your super amazing Giganto, or you get on your Battle Beaver, you go out, you do some stuff and things for 10 minutes or so, and then you gotta AFK for like 15 minutes in order to get them to heal up. And it's just kind of frustrating because it's not that way with carnivores. Now, you know, the guys that over at Ark, they could be doing this so that... Oh, Beaver. Is it a Battle Beaver? Are you a second Battle Beaver? You're just a little Battle Beaver. Oh, hello, stupid snake. You want some of this? You're a low-level beaver. You must be culled. We must cull the herd. So, oh, wait. What do we got going on over here? So, yeah, it just makes it frustrating because with the carnivores, you can't use... Or you can use them forever, indefinitely, or whatever. But you got to keep in mind, too, that what might be going on there is that they're kind of saying, like, you know, meat eaters are the attackers and herbivores just aren't. And that's just the way it is. But it kind of stinks because it's fun to have a Battle Beaver. I like having a Battle Beaver. I'm going to pump its HPs a little bit more. It's been really fun so far, but like I said, I've already spent probably half hour, 45 minutes AFK, just trying to get him to heal up. But I'm excited to go to the North Island. I want to go ahead. No. No compies. This is not for you. Let's go ahead and swim. It's going to be a little bit faster. I want to head up there. I want to see what we can do. I think that it will be super fun to probably try to take on some higher level stuff and things. What level are you, buddy? 48 Giganto. Probably worth some XP Zores. Let's go ahead and see if we can't take him out. But I think it will be a really good time to head up there. So, you want some of this hot action? Just took, that was 7 minutes of AFK right there. Just getting hit by that Giganto. So, yeah, like I said, I think it's going to be really fun. I'll meet you when we get up there. I will be Arby's, peeps. Oh, we're almost there. After so much AFK time and watching movies on Netflix, we have full health, Beaver. I can't believe it. It's too high, Gamma. All right, so we're at the North Island. We're ready to take on some stuff and things. We're going to see how our Battle Beaver does. 3188 health, 434% melee damage. Where's the bad guys? Are there bad guys? We came all this way. We came all this way just to see you, bad guys. Is that a dodo? No, it's a rock. We came all this way to see the bad hombres. Where's the bad hombres? There's some around here, I bet. One day, we'll find them. Are there some? Oh, okay, here we go. All right, we're in it. Two Carnos. Let's get them up here. 80, 28, 24, 32. Okay, nothing super crazy. This is going to be kind of a big battle, though. This is our first big battle test with the Battle Beaver Peckle Knuckle. If you can say that three times fast, oh, baby, I'll tell you what. I'm pretty impressed. Bring it on, stupid Carno! Oh, he's not really performing quite as well as I would have hoped. Oh, we're stuck! Oh, no, we got another Carno coming in. This should be an easy kill. All right, we got a level. We didn't lose that much HPs. Give me that hot melee damage action. All right. Here we are. Oh, this could be bad. Let's take it slow. Not everybody at once. Oh, peace out, Sabertooth. One of these raptors. Oh, all done. Okay, Scorpion. We got some more Saber up here. I'm hoping we see a T-Rex. I really want to see how the Battle Beaver takes the T-Rex down. Okay, we got that guy. I saw some Argies over here. I want to see. Can a beaver kill a bird? Pickle Knuckle, you got some bird power, killing power? There was some over here. Oh, here it is. Here we go. A whole batch of them. What are they doing? They're worshiping the ground sand area. Here we go. Oh, yeah, baby. That's what's up. Simple, easy peasy, lemon squeezy. We killed them all. What do we got over here? There's another bird. This should be simple. Oh, he's sexually black. Wait, why? What? Can we take that part out of the video, please? 52, nothing. That was easy. All right, so the big island. Where is the big island? All right, here it is. We got any hot T-Rex action around here? I'm not sure. Oh, there's one. Oh, I'm a little bit afraid. What level are you? 16, okay. Oh, there's another one right there. What level are you? 56. There's a huge battle. Let's make a beeline. Get it, beaver? All right. We got to get over there before that T-Rex dies. Oh, there's a whole big problem. Oh, this is going to be a big battle. Okay, we're almost in. Don't die, T-Rex. I'm going to take you out. All right. Jumping in the fray. We're in the fray. Oh, baby, we got it. I mean, I think we had a little bit of help. Come over here. You want some of this hot action, Argentavis? All right, T-Rex number two. He's already way hurt, and this guy's the lower level one anyway. This should be pretty straightforward. And a scorpion, also damaged. Nailed it. Aced it, can't be stopped. I think we got to make a couple more passes on the island here and see what we can't get done with this beaver. And we're back after another long stint of AFK to heal. There's a huge amount of bad hombres in this area. Let's see what we can do with it. Come over here, homie. You want some of this hot beaver action? That's right, level 8 Carno. What are you even... What? Oh, double Carnos. Dude, this guy's getting powerful. I got him up to a little over 500% melee damage now. Oh, baby! Oh, yeah. Let's check out the stats again. 509% melee damage, 3,700 health, and we're at level 175. So 20 levels higher than when we initially tamed it. We're at only 2,300 experience to get to next level. The biggest thing that holds me back from leveling this guy up is that every time I take him around the island, I got to wait about a half an hour to 40 minutes or so for him to heal back up. So I could get it to be much higher. It's just going to take a little bit of time. And then it kind of stinks where my base is. If I want to come up here to level, I guess it's not that long because we could probably just swim. You know, we'll take a look on the way back. We'll go ahead and swim her back, and see how long it's going to take us to swim up here. But so far, so good. This guy's pretty great. Oh, yeah, that's what's up. Oh, we got some hot T-Rex action in the area. I was hoping maybe... Oh, a level 88. Oh, my God. I was hoping maybe to see an alpha, like a low-level alpha, but I don't think it would be a good idea right now. All right, huge battle coming up over here. Let's go ahead and head in. Strategically, we are going to aim for the Buck Cloaca, as you all know, the most vulnerable spot of any dinosaur. Here it is! Right your Buck Cloaca! Oh! Oh! Oh, yeah! 88 T-Rex dead! I think there's another scorpion around here somewhere. Did I get it? Is it dead? Is it gone? Did we do it? All right, we did it. Let's go ahead and do health again. 4,000. We got two levels off of that. 524% melee damage now. We're killing it, peeps! I gotta say, I think our battle beaver is coming along quite nicely. And we're back under cover of darkness. I'm noticing something interesting about this beaver. I've been swimming around with him. And if you unmount him while you're underwater, it automatically like floats all the way to the top. I don't know if other dinos do that. I don't believe so. So that's kind of a weird mechanic. Like I don't want to swim down too far, but I mean, look. Like he just goes all the way to the top, like instantly. I wonder if you could use that as like a water elevator. You could use it to get items from down bottom up to the top pretty quick. And the other thing I wanted to test out is, let's go ahead and see what happens when we fight a shark. I mean, this could be like a real cool thing. Let's see. I mean, I think it's going to be pretty straightforward. His maneuverability is really good underwater. He turns corners really tight. And when you stop moving with him, like he just stops, which is great. This guy is an underwater guy. I don't know. It's kind of powerful. Like, I think Mazion did this too, and I didn't get a chance to check out his video about his battle beaver, but, like, these guys are kind of OP. Like, their ability to swim and turn and stop, and the fact that they have a really tight turning radius, which you know is why the dinosaurs went extinct. I've talked about this several times. Obviously, leading cause of dinosaur extinction, poor turning radius. We've seen this from mosasaurs, T-Rexes. We've seen this from plesiosaurs. We know that that's a huge issue in the dinosaur community. So, but with this guy, the turning radius is so tight. No wonder beavers went on to, you know, be beavers. And we're back with a rather large adversary. Oh, you want some of this hot beaver action? Is that what you're looking for, Bronto? Because you're going to get some. That's what you want. That's what you're asking for. That's what you're looking for in your life, is to be dead. You won. All right, so we're back at home base, peeps, with our battle beaver. We got another level. Let's go ahead and pop that into melee damage. We did a good amount of stuff and things today, and I got to say a couple of things. First of all, we got to remember to thank DMAC very much for the replacement Mastercraft battle club. And then we got to thank Drax so much for dropping this off. You know, these beavers are rare, man. They're not really easy to find. And getting 104, that was really, really fortuitous. Very, very cool. So we got to bring Pickle Knuckle inside to the base. And we're going to park it over here by Winona. Oh, yeah, that's what's up. Right there. Well, we'll leave her here for now. But look at it. Look at her. She's amazing. So amazing. So, yeah, cool. All right, guys. Well, I got to tell you what. That's going to be it for today, peeps. Thanks so much for hanging out. If you guys liked the video, please don't forget to hit the like button and show your support. Feel free to share and favorite the video as you see fit. May the stuff and things be with you.